Praise God. Good evening, everyone. How was everyone? Amen. I didn't ask you how you felt. I just said, how was everyone? Yes, we are blessed and highly flavored. We are the light and the salt of this world. And we are the thorn to the unrighteous. Isn't that sweet? Glory. Thank you, Master. Turn to Romans chapter 12 for one moment. Is everybody there? Hey, we're not bound by time, right? Space or time. Woohoo! Romans 12, verse 1. Let's speak it. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service or your responsibility. In other words, he's expressing something vitally important. He's saying, you need to make an exchange. And then he confirms it by, he says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that is good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. In other words, I said, Lord, what do you want to talk about tonight? And clearly he said, exchange rate. I said, exchange rate. You know, everybody's caught up in exchange rates. You know, everybody looks for a good deal. When people look for an exchange rate, they're usually thinking financially, to make an exchange for a higher rate so there's a better income. But this is what he told me. He said the value of the level of exchange and the rate of speed to exchange and the level of comprehension to apply the exchange, always looking for a higher rate of exchange. For what? The purpose of this is to advance, to profit, and to expand. To advance, to profit, and to expand. So what is he saying? He's saying, look at the exchange rate means it's a level, the value of the level of exchange. In other words, it's the rate of speed to exchange something. And I can tell you when somebody comes home, sometimes somebody might buy something at the store. Especially, I know women are very particular about certain things. If they buy something that they grab the wrong thing or doesn't, you know, they realize on the way home that it's the wrong one, believe me, they will slam on the brakes, turn around, and go back and exchange it. If I realize that I've bought something that, you know, and I'm close enough to return it, I will turn around and return it. But there's an exchange rate. The quicker you exchange, the better. That is the value of the rate. Now, the importance of this is to reach a level of comprehension to where we have an understanding to apply the exchange. So we are always looking for an opportunity for a higher rate. God is always, listen, this is why you and I go through things. The problem is most people aren't seeing it. They get so caught up in their problems and circumstances, they're not seeing that there's an opportunity for an exchange rate. And they miss the opportunities. Is everybody okay? Why? Because if we're always looking for a higher exchange rate, in other words, the more difficult something is, the more higher the rate will be. Those are great opportunities. So when we are looking for a higher exchange rate, when we accept that higher exchange rate, what it does is three things. It advances us, it brings us profit, and it expands every time. Now, you may not see it and feel it at that moment, but there will be a ripple effect to it. It will come. In Ephesians 3, exchange rate. Strange thing. It's called the exchange rate. Oh, hallelujah. Ephesians 3:14. For this reason, I bow my knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, from whom the whole family in heaven and earth are named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might through his Spirit in the inner man. Through his Spirit. Nothing else. Through his Spirit. That Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width, length, and depth, and height, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you may be filled with the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that works in us, to him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. In other words, we are to be strengthened by his Spirit in our inner man. We are to be grounded in his love. In other words, it's his love towards us. And we are to comprehend. That is associated with understanding and to put into active work so that you and I get an understanding. What is comprehension? So that we have an understanding. Listen, there's more than just understanding. Because the reality is, if you truly understand it, you're going to put it into active work. But if you don't understand it, you're not going to put it into active work. That's the comprehension. Why? In hope to be filled with his fullness and everything that we do. You know, many times, again, the arena being connected. Many people are connected to the Word of God, but not the presence of God. Being connected to just the Word of God and not the presence of God will put you in a lukewarm state. People can quote Scripture. So, I love reading my Bible all day long. Well, what about worship? Well, I don't really worship much. See, you got to connect in worship. Connection in worship is essential. What the devil looks for someone is who's passive. See, you can sing the words, but not sing to him. What you are doing is you're singing to make connection. So you're singing to him. You should be talking to him, singing right to him. Why? Then you make connection. You know what happens when you make connection? You disappear. And so do all your troubles and all your worries and all your concerns. You disappear. If you haven't made connection, you're still there. Then you're relying on you and not him. See, because worship is the first arena of make exchange. That is the great exchange rate, is worship. So many people do not make connection. You know when you've made connection. Because it's no longer about you. It's all about him. Is everybody okay? Ephesians 4. Exchange rate. The value, the level of exchange. To exchange. You know, if you hold on to something hot, let's say you picked up a hot coal. Sometimes it takes a minute for your brain to say, hurt, burn, kill you. Ooh. The quicker you exchange, the less you get scarred. The quicker you let it go, the quicker it heals. That's why many people are still bound by offense, resentment, rejection, what was me, oppression, because they really never exchanged it. And you must have the strength to exchange it. He says, by his Spirit, your inner man will be strong. That's why worship, making connection in worship, strengthens your inner man. Without making connection, you don't have strength. You have nothing. You have letter. But if you don't have presence, you're weak. Easily swayed. led by emotion. Ephesians 4:11. Is everybody okay? Let's speak it. Ephesians 4:11. And he himself gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers for what? For the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, to a what? Perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Why? So that we're no longer children, tossed to and fro, carried about with every wind of doctrine and every emotion, by the trickery of men, in cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting, but we are speaking the truth in love, and that we may grow up in all things into him who is the head, Christ, from whom the whole body joined and knit together by what every joint supplies, according to its effective working by which every part does its share. The power cannot do its share without being connected. It's impossible. You know why? They're so busy about their own life, they can't participate about the kingdom life. Then it causes growth of the body for the edifying of itself in love. Remember, there's equipping and perfecting of the saints, so there's a perfect harmony in the Spirit. Not only in the Spirit, but with the Spirit. For the Spirit is always awake, so that your spirit is always awake. It's not asleep. It's alert. It's got its antennas up. Beep, beep, beep. Sonar, radar. Doesn't matter whether you're underwater or flying in the air. Always awake. And you're waiting. You're waiting for the opportunity for a higher rate of exchange. What does that involve in your past? And your present? What are you exchanging for your future? See, many people don't realize that they're still living in the past to the present and not from the future to the present. And you cannot live from the future to the present unless you are connected. It's impossible. You can say it. You can want to believe it. But it's impossible to happen unless you're connected. Because if you're not connected to the present, you're not connected to the future. Because only when you're connected to the presence are you connected to every area. And that's where the word says that we are blessed with every spiritual blessing and seated in heavenly places. Well, my goodness, if we're seated in heavenly places and blessed with every spiritual blessing, we should lack nothing. In fact, we shouldn't even need anything. We know that all of our needs will be met when it's time. Boom, boom, boom. Falls right into place. Other than that, people are still crying out, Lord, I need this. Lord, I need that. He's saying, get in position. Get connected. I know what your need is. If you ever see a shoe come out of heaven, you know why. Boom. Might be a sandal. Save it, whatever you do. Hallelujah. In Philippians 1. Oh, happy day. Turn to your neighbor and say, God loves you. Even when you don't love you. Got real quiet when everybody tried to say that part. God loves you. Even when you don't love you. Hallelujah. Philippians 1, verse 3. I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine, making requests for you in all, with all joy, for your fellowship in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will what? Will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Just as it is right for me to think this of you all, because I have you in my heart, inasmuch as both in my chains and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel, you are all partakers with me of grace. For God is my witness how greatly I long for you with all the affection of Jesus Christ. And this I pray, that your love may abound still more and more in the knowledge and all discernment, that you may approve the things that are excellent, and that you may be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. He who began the good work will complete it with your permission. Does everybody get it? With your permission, cooperation, and the ability of the rate of exchange. Three things. Takes your permission, your cooperation, and the ability of the rate of exchange. So that means that you and I must be not only awake, but aware. It takes your permission, your cooperation, and the ability of the rate of exchange. Philippians 3. Exchange rate. Philippians 3, verse 1. Is everybody there? Didn't have far to go, did you? Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. For me to write the same things to you is not tedious, but for it is safe. Beware of dogs. Believe me, he's not talking about, you know, chuchihuahuas and stuff like that. He's talking about humans that are demonized. Beware of evil workers. Beware of the mutilation. For we are the circumcision who worship God in the Spirit. Rejoice in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh. Though I also might have confidence in the flesh, if anyone else thinks he might may have confidence in the flesh, I more so circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel, the tribe of Benjamin, and a Hebrew of the Hebrews, concerning the law and a Pharisee, concerning zeal persecuting the church. So he was expressing his zealous for the Lord on the wrong path. Concerning the righteousness which is in the law, blameless. But what things were gained to me, these I have counted loss for Christ. Yet indeed I also count all things lost for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ. Look at, you talk about an exchange rate. Paul made the ultimate exchange rate. This is what he kept saying. Paul kept looking for an opportunity for the highest rate of exchange. Anything that was bothering him, anything that was hindering him, he looked for the most highest rate of exchange. Bam, he exchanged it. He did not get stuck in the present. He did not get stuck in the past. He exchanged himself to be stuck in the future. And look at the revelation God gave him. I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ and be found in him. Well, that means that there's something he had to do. He had to give the permission, the cooperation, and the ability to exchange to the Holy Spirit. and be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ Jesus, the righteousness which is from God by faith, that I may know him. That I may what? See, so many times people think they know him, but they really don't. They don't really know him. Because people wouldn't do the things they do if they really knew him. Does everybody understand it? When a person really knows the Lord, they think like him, they see like him, they want like him, they desire what he desires. There's an exchange made. That I may know him in the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being conformed to his what? Death. What an exchange. Death for life. If by any means I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. In other words, he is expressing something very important. No confidence in the flesh or self. None. Our confidence and trust can only be placed in the Lord. That's when we give him permission to cooperate and allowing him to sift our self-confidence, our abilities, our talents, our strengths, our successes, our failures, our wants. Because when we don't do that, we deny him access. And that what happens then, when you deny him access, it promotes pride and anxiousness. I'm going to say that again. When you deny him access, you will begin to fall into pride and anxiousness. That are two signs you know that you've just denied the Lord access. The word says, make no place for the devil. Well, the devil's always trying to replace the Lord. Amen? When you fall into pride and you fall into anxiousness, you can be sure that you just rejected the Lord's access to something or you refuse to exchange it. Proverbs 3. Proverbs 3, we'll start at verse 1. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. My son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commands. For length of days and long life and peace they will add to you. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, and so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart, not part, all. And lean not on your own understanding, exchange it. And all of your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. That is so powerful. That should be a prayer for you and me every single day. Lord, I commit to you my ways. I exchange my ways for your ways. Amen? I acknowledge you in all of my ways. I'm asking that you'll establish my steps and thoughts. I cast my cares upon you, for you care for me. You're making exchanges. You're part, almost 50% of your prayers, almost exchanging everything. And then your warfare. Because you can't warfare in self mode. You warfare in the anointing. And only can you have victory in the anointing, not in self. So there's got to be an exchange in the beginning. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he's going to direct your path. Don't be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. Very, very powerful. Don't forget the requirements of freedom and victory. And the formula of denying yourself, pick up the cross and fight and follow until the exchange rate of the formula becomes a living, active, and aggressive in the spirit. See, every day we are following the formula. Deny yourself, pick up the cross, and follow. It should come to a place where it's no longer a formula. It's life. There is no thought about it. It is. Does everybody understand? Because you are living now. Now, the Word is living. When it's backed by the Spirit of God, it's living. So you and I should be the living Word now. We should be living in the Word, because the Word of God is Jesus. That means we are living in His presence, but we must be connected to His presence. So in this is powerful. We must come to a place where the exchange is constant, because you must deny yourself. You must pick up the cross and fight. It is the only way to follow. That is the formula. It should come to a point where it's no longer a formula. It just is. It's automatic. When it becomes automatic, it becomes living and active and aggressive. While you're then it allows you to get into the Spirit. No longer a formula, but a life activity that you and I perform every single moment, every decision, and every day. Everything. It's not a formula. It's an activity. It's a life. Why? Because it's been exchanged. 1 John chapter 1. The higher rate of exchange, the more you advance. The more you profit. The more God trusts you. The more consistent you are at this, the more God can trust you. First John chapter 1, verse 5. This is the message which we have heard from Him and declare to you, that God is light and in Him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with Him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all sin. That's simple enough. That is the message. Amen? So there's an area where you and I must practice the truth. We must practice the constant exchange. And always looking for the highest exchange rate. In 1 John chapter 3. Little children, let no one deceive you. He who practices righteousness is righteous, just as He is righteous. He who sins is of the devil. For the devil has sinned from the beginning. In other words, when somebody begins to sin, it's because they're influenced. Again, we talked about something, what was it, Sunday? In the area to where, why do people get moved? Change course? Because of the lack of the strength to resist? That means lack of connection again. They can't resist. They can't resist the influence. They can't resist the emotional. They can't resist the temptations. They can't resist. Lack of strength. Hallelujah. So he who sins is of the devil, for the devil has sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that He might destroy the works of the devil. And for this you and I have been born again, that we can continue the ministry of destroying the works of the devil. And this is the children of God, and whoever has been born of God does not sin. For a seed remains in him, and he cannot sin because he has been born of God. And this, the children of God and the children of the devil are manifested. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor is he who does not love his brother. For this is the message that you heard from the beginning, that we should love one another, not as Cain, who was of the wicked one and murdered his brother. And why did he murder him? Because his works were evil and his brother's righteous. In other words, we are to practice the rate of exchanging your old for new. Your old for new. It's a constant. It's a life formula now. Deny yourself, pick up the cross, follow. It's a constant. It's not a moment. It is constant. Everything that is bothering you the most, you're always looking for the highest rate of exchange. What is it? Exchange it quickly. Again, when people are constantly relying self-confidence, self-abilities, self-ambitions, selfish desires, all of those things will nullify access by the Holy Spirit. There will be no cooperation because he isn't going to cooperate with you or me if we do that. 2 Corinthians 5. Thank God for repentance and turning away. He's merciful. He gives us multiple chances. But why keep going around the same old mountain? Second Corinthians chapter 5, verse 16. Therefore, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things pass away. Behold, all things become new. That takes cooperation. That takes searching out opportunities for an exchange rate. Now, all things are of God who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and have given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself and not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us, everyone say committed to me, the word of reconciliation. Then we are what? Ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. God can't plead through selfish ambitions, self-confidence. Only through our deadness and trust can he plead through us. Amen? Romans 8. One of the things you'll realize is, what is your greatest fear? You'll come to a place of, what is your greatest fear? That is your highest ability of exchange rate. Search it. You know, so many times people ignore it. Where is that place where you feel you're the strongest in? Where is that place you feel or sense that you are the weakest in? What is the same thing that keeps coming up that causes us to stumble? What is the same area of attitude that's constantly released? What is it that you know is not a character of Christ that constantly comes up? That's the one you look for, because that's a high rate of exchange. The quicker you exchange it, the better. But I keep exchanging and it keeps coming back because you're not connected. If you're connected, it can't come back. Why? Because when you're connected, you're covered. What goes out can't come back. When you're not connected, it has access. Hallelujah. Romans 8, 28. Let's speak it together. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. That's powerful. Man, you're going to get into a position and place that no matter what's going on, it's going to work to the good, even your mistake. Hello? if you're willing to cooperate and look, opportunity to search for the greatest exchange rate, it's going to work to the good. Everything will work to the good that's connected and under the blood. You may have a few bumps, a few bruises, a few scars, but it's going to work to the good. Amen? Hallelujah. Verse 29, for whom he foreknew, he also what? Predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, and that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he predestined, these he also called. Whom he called, these he also justified. And whom he justified, these he also glorified. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall we not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies, and who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore, is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for you and me. Thank you, Jesus. I need your intercession. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. All day long. You are a sweet smelling aroma to God. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. In other words, his love for you and me is unconditional. Amen. We are reaching a level of perfect completion in him with full trust that all things will work to the good. Listen, it's very hard to have that level of faith and that level of trust if you're not exchanged. It's very difficult. Why? Because you're still always working on you. Everything's about you, 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 you. When it should be about him, 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 him. The more you exchange you, the more you got him. Amen? And the more things you can progress on. So we're always looking at reaching the level of perfect completion in him with full trust that all things will work to the good by maintaining a positional course of destiny according to his will and his time. Psalm 34. Psalm 34. In verse 8. You know, after getting baptized, filled, I was out on bail. One of the things the Lord kept sharing with me is trust me. And he kept telling me, speak it. Don't think it, speak it. Don't worry about thinking it. Because as I spoke it, I ate it. Then I wasn't having to think about it, I was living it. And then when I went before the judge, I didn't care. Whatever you want me to do, Lord. Because my life was no longer mine. It was in his hands. And I trusted whatever open door he chose, whatever he chose to do, I would serve him and love him no matter what the outcome was. Because I know his plan and his way was better than mine. That was a high rate of exchange. And I walked out of the courtroom. And within a couple months later, my wife and I were restored. But it wasn't according to my time, it was his time. Whatever he wanted to do. Again, we want, look at, no matter what, I knew it was everything was going to work to the good. Wherever he sent me, it didn't matter. See, when you're still fighting for your life, it's a terrible place to be. Terrible. It's torment. It's terrible. I hate fighting for my life. In fact, I hate my life. But I love his life. And I found it and realized that there was a high rate of exchange. That's why he says you're supposed to hate your life and exchange your life. But so easily we fall into that trap and fight for our life again. And we fall into pride and anxiousness. Well, I can do a better job. Or I could do this. Three I's and you're out. I. That should be a sign right there. When you got three I's. I this. You need to I out. Because that's all you're making is a demonic pizza, right? I. Hallelujah. Again, we need to, in verse 8 it says, taste and see that the what? Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in him. Listen, if you're blessed, are you favored? Snapping yes. Oh, fear the Lord, you his saints. That means reverence, honor, and respect him. There is no what? Oh, snap it. Now, come on, wait a minute. There's no what? There is no want to those who reverence him. Why? Because they're connected and they know he's going to do whatever it needs to do. All things are going to work to the good. No matter what. Why? Because you've fallen into a life of trust. You've fallen into a life where you're leaning on him and not you. And you know that when your own understanding starts coming up and you start calculating everything in your little peanut brain. Beep, beep, beep. You get rid of it. Exchange it. Get rid of it. Because we know that the enemy's arena is fear. Fear. What if? What if? Yeah, what if? What if you were to do what you were supposed to do? Hallelujah. See, but we always have a tendency to go back. Well, if I would have done this, forget it. It's too late. Cut it loose and do what you're supposed to do now. Just do it and trust God. You know, again, what hinders individuals from making that exchange is fear. Well, what if God doesn't do it? He's probably thinking the same thing about you. What if you don't do it? Listen, he can't trust someone who can't trust him. You may trust them in something, but not in everything. And that's what he's looking for. He wants our complete life, not part of it. He wants it all. Psalm 37. Psalm 37, first 8 verses. You know, it's a great thing to fall into a place where you don't care about yourself no more. And I, don't get me wrong in it. I mean, you know, it doesn't mean you're never going to shower again or something like that, you know. I mean, you're going to care about yourself. I mean, that arena to where your life is totally trusted in the hands of God. Totally. There isn't any worry, there isn't any fear, there isn't any anxiousness. It's a wonderful place to be. And I'm not going to say that you're not going to step on that little button that releases anger, fear, anxiousness, and everything else, but you take your foot off of it. You know when to come, oh, I'm not. Don't go there. They used to have this at this amusement park. It was one of these, when I was a kid, they had this building at this amusement park, and it's kind of a frightening thing, you know. But they would frighten you on air. It would blow out from everywhere. You didn't know where it was coming from. And next thing you'd step on this thing, and the air would blow out, and you'd go into this other place, and you'd lean on something, and the air would blow you across the room, you know, or whatever. It's the same thing. That's how fear works. You step on it and it blows on you. Psalm 37, verse 1. Do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of other workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on his faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the what? The desires of your heart. Now, those desires are his because there's been a high rate of exchange. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret because of him who prospers in his way, because of men who brings schemes to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath, and do not fret. It only causes harm. Trust, rest, wait, exchange. Psalm something. 121. Couldn't read my writing there for a minute. Everyone say trust. Yes. Trust. Yes. Trust. Yes. Trust. Yes. Trust. Yes. Psalm 121. Is everybody there? Anybody there? Yes. Praise God. We are going to confess this. Is everybody there? Speak it. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow my foot to be moved. He who keeps me will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is my keeper. The Lord is my shade at his right hand. The sun shall not strike me by day nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve me from all evil. He shall preserve my soul. The Lord shall preserve my going out and going in from this time forth and even forevermore. We've got to get to a place where we are hungry enough to be fed. We are thirsty enough to cry out. And we are broken enough that we don't want anything in the world unless he comes himself. Always looking for an opportunity for a good exchange rate. We must maintain an area of hunger, of thirst, and brokenness. We must search ourselves in every area, whatever it is, which is a thorn in you. God wants to exchange it. The quicker you do it, the better. Amen. Father, we are honored and blessed for your word. We help us to see the opportunities of a high rate of exchange, that we may earn your trust, Lord, and that we may be your witnesses of truth and power. Surrender. Totally sold out, trusting in you. Not in our own abilities or self-confidence, but totally trusting in you. Because we trust all things are going to work to the good as you make the way in Jesus' name. Everybody said amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Be blessed and stay dressed with the glory.